Hello, I'm Robert Vaassen, energy engineer, and today in video number 20 we will talk about this air water heat pump, also called swimming pool heat pump in this case, and we will see how we can use it in a complete way with the cold and with the hot side. Look to this video until the end, because at the end there will be a challenge for you. So now we have to decide how we will use the cold and also the hot side. Now the cold side is not a problem because it is summer. Now in this moment it's 30 degrees here on 850 meters above sea level in Sicily on Mount Etna. So, and the heat can also be interesting, as you saw. We can use it for the dishwasher, for the washing machine, but also of course for the showers. But all those domestic appliances, they take the water from the cold tap. Then we have to put the warm water of the heat pump into the cold grid of the house. But anyway, who is interested in cold water from the cold tap? Why is it so bad if it is, for example, 30 degrees? It's only good for your hands, or at least less harmful. What really is the point here is that we want cold water into our heat pump in such a way that we can run it at a high efficiency. Now let me know in the comments what you think about the uses of heat and cold. How do you use the cold? Okay, the cold. So now let's look how we implement that. This heat pump has been designed to heat up a swimming pool. So that means it has the warm circuit, it is a water circuit. Other circuits, so on the cold side, it is cold air, and heat which is taken from this air is going into the water. Now, as I said before, if you can take cold water, then the temperature difference between this cold water and the temperature of the air, which must also be cold, will be much smaller than is between the air conditioner, between the cold air in the living room and the hot air on the street. So that means the heat pump in this case will have an easier job, and it will reward you with more efficiency. Now the heat pump must be placed inside the house, and that's because it's too difficult to transport cold air. Water is much easier. So what do you do? You put it in the living room, but then it might be too noisy, and so you need their solution. Well, I will deal with that. Okay, that's the air circuit, and now the water circuit, so the warm side. And there you can do two things. One thing is that you just let in the cold water from the public grid, which is more or less at 15 to 20 degrees, and then that is so-called, that will give you this high efficiency of the heat pump. But then you have the problem that you don't know when you consume this cold water, because you need a flow, otherwise he cannot work. So what is then there? The solution is that you bring this cold water into a tank, and in Italy there are many houses with tanks of 500 liter or 1000 liter, and that's because there is the security of supply, and that is a problem in many houses. Let's say you have this water supply, this water tank, where the cold water is going in, and then you can take this water, go send it into a heat pump, and then go back, and then you can circulate it. So that means that you can take the heat and you can create a flow inside the water side of the heat pump when you need cold in your house. So that's flexibility. But in that case, you will have tepid water in your cold water grid in the house. And I think for me it would not be a problem, because if I wash my hands or I do anything, then it's for me only nice to have water of let's say 30 degrees. The only thing is that you have to consume it rather quickly in a few days, because otherwise you will get problems with hygiene. Well, as you see, in our case, we have more flexibility because we have two containers for the water supply. And we can use one tank with this heat pump and the other which stays cold, and then we can choose which we use. Okay, now I will show you all the experiments which I did with this heat pump. And of course I wrote all the values, like the temperatures and the power. That's during 1.5 hours. And I produced also during that 90 minutes this quarter liter of water, distilled water. You can use it for the iron or maybe for the car, I don't know. Anyway, this is water which has been in the air. And that's of course also an advantage of this heat pump, because it will make the air more comfortable. So we did the experiments, and it functioned well. Apart from this quarter liter of water which we produced, we had also a nice cool living room where the air was also less humid. And every quarter of an hour, the tank of 400 liter was raised by 1 degree. I gave, of course, a lot of options what you can do with the cold water. You take it directly, you put it in a tank, you put the heat pump inside or outside, so it might be overwhelming. But you have just to see what you want, what is feasible in your home, what are the advantages and the disadvantages, and you have then to choose, as always. The scope of my video is that I give you this choice, because otherwise, if you just buy what's available, okay, it can be practical, but sometimes you want to be in between the choices which society gives you. And if you don't come out of this freedom of choice, well, then you write in the comments and I can help you. And now is the challenge. So I give you the task to write in the comments what you would do with this heat pump which makes a noise in your living room, what you would do to deal with it. And also, how would you organize the water circuit for this heat pump in the rest of the house. I will wait until I have 10 answers, and then at number 10 I will write there under what I think of it. I will very honestly say if I thought about it or it is really a new idea from your side, and I am really curious about what comes out of this challenge. Now, by the way, I mentioned my friend who wants to make a cellar for the fruit in his house. We have the same idea here. We have a cellar. We have a piece of land higher up the mountain where we have pears, apples and also other fruit. And then at the harvest we have the problem or to sell it right away or to keep it. But then we have to keep it at a low temperature. So this is the ideal solution to cool such a room. And to help you a little bit with the challenge, the noise in the fruit cellar is not a problem. So I hope that you like these ideas and that you will participate in the challenge. And if you like this video, then please put your thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to it so that I can go on to bring you new ideas and to make you more independent from the energy infrastructure and keep the costs down. I wish you good energy.